This house dates back to 1806, where it belonged to a family called the Epps. Then it was Summers Residential Club, and then after that it changed its name to Ormsby Court Residential Home, where I worked in the 90s, and my mother worked here for a hell of a long time. But this place has some stories that need to be told. Ivy Villa, built around 1806. It was one of three mansions owned by the Epps family. The others were Norfolk House and Biggingwood House, which no longer exist. The Epps family was in every sense a phenomenal homeopathic family, comprising several homeopathic physicians and pharmacists. Their main pharmacy was established in 1839 at Jermyn Street, London, which now stands as a portrait gallery. In 1839, James Epps also started a business in importing and exporting cocoa from a plantation in Jamaica, where it was shipped to the UK, which lasted until 1930. By 1879, the Epps family purchased land in Norwood, where they built three houses, Biggingwood House being the main family home where James Epps and his wife Sarah lived for over 30 years. Finally, the house was left unoccupied from 1935 after their deaths. Ivy Villa was occupied by various members of the Epps family until 1927, where it was then left abandoned for many years until it was then converted into Summers Residential Club for the elderly. In 1987, it was then purchased by Raglan Housing Association and renovated into a private care home known as Ormsby Court, where the residents would see out the rest of their lives. My mother worked at Ormsby Court for many years and heard stories from the night staff. Whilst they'll be on night shift, they would see and hear strange things. And on one occasion, a figure was seen in the dining hall of an unknown woman, standing looking through the window. In the 1990s, I also worked at Ormsby Court, where I saw abuse take place by one of the managers on an elderly lady. A few weeks later, the lady died. I took my mother for a tour of what was left of the building, and she was saddened by how it has just been left to decay. Her memories are ones of smiles and friendships with the residents there, which she still keeps safe. There were many deaths here before the building closed its doors in 2004. On our daytime walkthrough whilst filming, we heard doors opening and close. Voices were also captured on our camera's audio. These voices are of two women saying their names. One says Holton, followed by another voice which says Scots. Investigation at Ivy Villa. With so many events embedded within the walls and fibres of this old building, and the voices and opening of doors captured in the daytime, we were hoping that whatever is here will let themselves known. We made our way through the corridors to the main dining area, and within minutes, our expectations of Ivy Villa were coming to life. Okay then, Jace. Movement in front of me already. There was two steps.
That's just a dog.
Yeah, it's a dog bark in the background, but there, Jay. There was some sort of movement. Okay, let's see if we can... And again. A movement at this doorway, Jay.
Was that a ting?
Was that you?
No, it went up, it was over there somewhere.
A movement at this doorway, Jay. Movement at this doorway, Jay. Are any of the residents that used to stay here still here? Did you hear that?
It sounds like someone's moving.
That's what I'm saying. That's not the first time. Hold on, Jay. I've got my camera on that area, okay, so don't worry about it. I've got it covered.
Okay.
If any of the residents are still here, can you let us know? Do you remember me? I was one of the good guys. I used to bring you your dinners. I used to cook your dinners. I used to cook your dinners. I used to cook your dinners. Let's go up to the first floor, because that's where something happened. As Jason pans the camera down to the ground floor, a shadow figure is caught moving from right to left by the main door. Here is the footage again, enhanced and in slow motion. So, this is probably my worst memory, and that's in this room. And there used to be a lady in here, really old, frail lady, her name was Annie. And sometimes she used to play games and make out that she's fallen over, that type of thing. And her bed was over here. That's where her bed was, just here in the corner. And one day we got a call saying that Annie had fallen over trying to get her cigarettes, because there used to be a cabinet here where her cigarettes used to be. And I came up here and she was laying on the floor. Right there. That's where she was laying, down on the floor. And I called for some help to get her up off the floor. And the manager came along. And I kid you not, she walked straight in, grabbed her arm, threw her across the room onto the bed in the corner, and walked out. And little Annie was screaming, and we just couldn't believe what had happened. I called for the other carers, and we ended up calling the police, and she got suspended, and then she got the sack, and then she had to go to court. And believe it or not, 2 weeks later, little Annie died. And these people, their families, they were paying £2,000 to £3,000 a month to have them stay in this private care home. And that's the sort of care they got. Annie? Are you still here? Are you still here in this room? Do you remember me? I helped you when you had that fall. Can you do something to let us know you're here? Can you make a noise?
Hey mate, Jeff. Camera's gone out of focus. I see it's back to normal now.
An EVP is captured as Jason's camera goes out of focus, saying, "I'm dead. Here's the enhanced audio."
Camera's gone out of focus.
Well, we've actually come back into Annie's room to get a night vision camera. We was just about to leave. We turned off all the cameras just to have a 5-10 minute break, and we went out into that hallway there, and there were shadows moving, and we could hear someone walking around, and we thought someone was coming up the stairs. That's how loud it was. And there's no one there whatsoever, because we've just now checked. So what we're going to do now, we're going to set up a night vision camera.
Is that where old Rusty door creak? Did you see that?
No, I was talking. I didn't hear it. This was exactly where we were standing just moments ago when we heard movement, and there was lots of shadows. So we're going to see if we can hear them again. So Jay, you film down in that direction, and I'm going to film down in this direction. Okay, here we go.
Is that door open?
Footsteps followed by movement can be heard, also the banging of doors. When Jason asks, "Was that door open?" an EVP is captured, saying no. Here's the enhanced audio.
I think I just could hear footsteps.
Who's here?
Is that door open?
Can you tell us your name? Can you shout out your name? In front of you.
Down there, somewhere, yeah, somewhere in front. I think it's saying down there. You hear some noises down that direction.
Who's down there? Who's with us? Who's with us? Who's with us? Is there anyone here that can hear me? Can you do something to let us know that you're here? Can you say something? Bang a door? Throw something to let us know that you're here? Can you shout out your name? Are you one of the residents that used to stay here? We carried out an EVP session on the main staircase, but nothing was captured, so we made our way to the top floor. Just trying to remember some of the names of the people that used to be here. We used to have Henry, Ben, Mrs. Mackenzie, Annie, Winnie. Are any of you still here? If you are, can you do something to let us know? I think I heard something then. Can you do that again? Stay dead still. Something's moving. As I pan my camera back down the hallway, we hear loud footsteps and walking. If you remember, a long time ago, there was a lady, a manager that worked here. Horrible person. Do you remember her? Is there anyone down there that can hear us? Anyone down on any of the floors that can hear us? Someone's moving. Again, movement and banging is heard from the floor below. Here's the enhanced audio. That gap there again, Joe.
I just heard a bang.
Joe, it came from behind you.
That's what I was thinking. Like a door sound.
There's that gap there again, Joe. That gap there again, Joe. Do you notice something? Joe?
What?
Do you notice something? Every time we leave a place or a room in this building, there's banging after we just come out of the place.
What, like playing games on us?
Are there any residents still here? Can you come and speak to us? Do you remember sitting in this room? watching telly, playing games. Do you remember the couple that used to come round and sing songs? Do you remember them? Jay? The bloody hairs on my legs have just gone right up and my arms. It's gone through my legs, right up my arms. Do you remember Margaret that used to work here in the kitchen? What the hell was that? Did you hear that, Jay? We both hear a disembodied voice, and after careful analysis of the voice, which is captured on the digital recorder, we believe the voice to be saying Ben. Do you remember Margaret that used to work here in the kitchen? What the hell was that? Do you remember Margaret that used to work here in the kitchen? Ben was a resident at Ormsby Court during the early 1990s, and he passed away in his room in 2002. Can you do something else? Anything at all? Anything at all. Just even a little noise. That's the second time something's moved. Just wait a second.
Did you hear humming? Did you just hear hum? Did you see that?
I heard something. I just saw it move. I just saw it move. I just see you. I saw you. I just saw it move right across the door at that. And I saw it. Where are you? I can't see a thing. I saw it move at the corner of my eye twice while we were talking, and then I put down my rucksack because I could see something standing there, and then as I looked, it was like I saw it and it saw me, and it went off to the right. I saw you. When I chased that shadow figure, it must have come this way, but I wonder where it went to. This here is more colder than...
Yeah, I'm absolutely freezing. I can feel my kneecaps. It's really cold.
Was it you that we saw in the dining room? We don't mean you no harm. We just come to speak to you. We wanted to visit this place before they change it all. They're going to change all this place and renovate it into something else. And we wanted to come here and speak to you before it's completely gone. On our investigation, I saw for the first time Jason take a step back as the dark corridor grew darker and moved towards him, but he stood his ground. Ivy Villa will always stay with me for many reasons. I will always remember the people I work with and also the residents that live there. I have seen many shadow figures on our investigations, and we have captured them on film many times, but never before have I locked eyes on one as it looked back at me. Ivy Villa was going to be renovated, but we have now been told that it will be demolished and leveled to the ground for new homes. Where will these souls go to that reside there? Inside the new homes that will be erected.